I don't know if I'm on, but I guess I am. So, hey y'all, it's your girl Dee Dee from WAB Audio Blog. As you know, we are back. It is 7:02 p.m. I am fashionably late. I'm going to connect this to the New York Fashion Week. So don't kill me because I'm 2 minutes behind. But I like to say to everybody, good evening. Hope everybody's doing well. Hope everybody got home from work. I hope you had a spectacular day. Everybody did exactly what they needed to do. Got all their goals together. Did all their projects. Got everything on time. Did all their paperwork. Went to school. Did all their term papers. All that other good stuff. Making sure everything is everything. All your ducks are in a line. Because that's what I'm trying to do. Put all my ducks in a line. And stuff like that. But that's why right now you should be home, have your feet up, getting ready to watch your programs. Whatever programs are coming on today on Wednesday. Empire's not on, people. So don't even... No. Empire, the new season's coming on in March. So just keep your panties on. You're here with me. So, but... anyway, I just want to say it's going to be some stuff that we're going to talk about, okay? Things I want to try to catch up on is this whole ordeal that they have been talking about with Apple. All your Apple fans, all that have all the Apple devices, the iPhones, iPads, the MacBooks, the MacBook Pros, the iPad Pro, the iPad Minis. All your Apple down true fans, I am seriously want to keep an eye on this whole thing with it's Apple versus FBI dealing with this whole terrorist event that happened a few months ago, a few weeks ago, trying to decide on whether having Apple take off the privacy code off of one of the terrorists that passed away, that got killed, iPhone, so they can do more investigations on to see if there's any other information that can help them on their investigation with the terrorist attack and all that stuff. I have my views on that. To me, to me, I'm looking at it in a bigger picture. And when it comes down to it, it's all about control and control of something. I know a lot of y'all must be saying that. What is she talking about? What is D actually talking about? But in all honesty, if y'all can't see the bigger picture, I don't know. Maybe it's just me. But to tell you honestly, it's coming. It's really, really, really common, and we all need to actually just look out and watch out for what's going to be going on behind the scenes. And to tell you honestly, you need to actually say to yourself, who has control of my life? Who has control of what I say, what I keep on my phone? Who has control of my freedom? In actuality, you know what I mean? This tell me if I'm right or tell me if I'm wrong. I don't know. I just don't understand, but I'm like saying to myself, it has to be about control.
This is a story about control.
Because control is one
my control.
Important thing.
If you control of what I say, control of what I do.
Everybody else has control.
And this time I'm gonna do it my way.
So this is the reason why I'm playing this song by Janet.
I hope you enjoy this as much as I do.
Really look at the
are we ready?
About that Apple
I am.
And the FBI.
Cause it's all about control. And I've got lots of it.
Listen to this and I'll be back. Listen to my audio blog. Love y'all. Be right back.
We'll be right back.
Was Janet Jackson, Control. And the reason why I'm playing that is because I am definitely want to follow what's going on with Apple and the FBI. Because people, if you don't really look at the different, not the different, but the connections of what the A and the B can equal to C, then I'm telling you, how I look at it, this is my opinion. Then a lot of people are lost because there's been a lot of ways. They've been trying to find ways to, this is how I look at it, to look at or to, how can I say, not look at, but try to get into people's phones and stuff like that. Now, I am, and I have to say, I'm a very big Apple fan. I have to say, I'm not going to front. I am a Apple fan, Apple down person. I mean, seriously, to the nine. I mean up and down. My iPad, iPod, iPhone, all that stuff. Whatever you can think of, I'm waiting for the iCar and iHouse and all that stuff. Apple down. But honestly, they will lose me if they side and give that right up and unlock the phone. Now, all your iPhone device holders, owners out there, know that they have a function on there that if your phone is either lost or your iPad is either lost or stolen, I think it's also if it's lost or stolen, and somebody tries to get into your phone, eventually you have to try to go through the password, because if they have your thumb, then or your finger, then they can get into it. But if they try make like at least 9 attempts to figure out what that password is, and they don't get it, but the 10th one they come across, then that causes the phone to actually erase everything off the phone and becomes a brand new phone. Now, I know some people, what's up, Gio? I see you coming up there, man. How you living, man? But I'm saying to myself is that what the FBI can actually do is that they can make an attempt. They can think about different things and what they can figure out what the password could be. You know, and that's all good and gravy. But if they make that I'm living nice, that's good, man. That's good. Bring some hot air up here. We need the heat. But that, yes, man. I need to send out my private jet down there, and so you and the family can come up. And then feel the cold and I can send y'all back. But this whole thing with Apple versus the FBI, it's the whole thing of how can I say, if they want the phone because they want a phone and they want to use it, FBI, that's fine. But in their policy, they have it that it kind of secures me that if somebody has my phone, I have a lot of important documents, important information. You people have their credit cards, their information, their birth dates, all this other stuff on the phones. And if they guarantee us that if somebody happens to get your phone, there's no way they can get in your phone, I feel secure. That's the reason why. That's the reason why I'm like, I dig Apple, because I know if I'm walking down the street and some person out of the blue takes my phone and they try to make those attempts, and they make the 10th attempt and they erase, okay, fine. But they don't want that to happen. They don't want it that if they make that 10th attempt to everything is erased, then the phone is not good to them. So that's the reason why they go into Apple. They go into the big wigs in Apple to say, well, listen, we want to crack this case. And we have a feeling that there are some stuff that's on that phone that might be good for us to figure out exactly if they're going to be any other stuff is going to happen. Do they have any plans, documents, something, some other people's names. I understand that. Don't get me wrong, people. I am against this terrorism and people terrorizing people to force them to believe in something that you don't want to believe. Again, that's control. You know, nobody's not going to control me. And I know people I know y'all don't want anybody to control you. So I am against terrorism. I'm against anybody terrorizing me or you or anybody else to force us to believe in something that we do not believe in. But if Apple's policy says that we have that anybody that buys our product, that we are securing you that your information cannot get into the hands of anybody. That's why they keep on making their products more advanced to a point that you have to cut off somebody's finger to go into people's phones. You understand what I'm saying? And I'm 100% with that. But in their policy, it actually shows me, okay, then fine. And to me, how I be seeing all these TV shows and stuff like that, they always have somebody smart to figure out. So don't the FBI got somebody that's smart that can crack into things on their own instead of asking Apple? Let them find some. I just don't understand. And I don't know if I'm talking out the crack of my ass. I'm sorry, people. I don't know if I'm talking out the crack of my ass, but this is a real big situation for me, and this is something real big in my eyes because I'm saying to myself, okay, now if, just if, Apple goes to the extent of saying to themselves, okay, I like terrorism. Maybe we might be able to help them. Maybe we could just help one. Yeah, I understand you help one, but then there's gonna be FBI, the CIA, then it's like CIA might come and say, well, you help the FBI and stuff like that, and then the CIA and the KGB, and then what? And then we have nothing. Even though this sounds so minuscule because it's so small. But look at the bigger picture. It's like the final piece to the picture. And when I look at it, I'm saying to myself, they've been trying so hard to find some way to say, well, we want to look in people's phone if we arrest people and stuff like that, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what do we have? That's about control. That's about having privacy. It's like, yo. If the person that got killed in a whole terrorist attack and stuff like that had that iPhone, they was here living, and they popped up and say, well, they go to them and say, listen, I want you to unlock your phone. And if they come up from there and say, yes, you use my phone, then fine. Then fine. Great. So be it. But that person is not on this earth. That person's not on this earth for them to give them the password, just to give them the okay to say, well, all right, I will. Until then, FBI don't have no right to get into that person's phone. I don't know if I'm the only one that sees it like this. Come on, Apple people, come on. I know there's a lot of people that have iPhones and stuff like that. What do y'all think about this? Because this is going to be huge. This is huge. That means anybody, they will say, well, Apple let us go through it. You know, we might just make it a law. Then what? Then they lost me if they side with them. They either side with them, or they have to change, or they have to change their whole damn policy or something. I don't know. This is crazy. I'm thinking long and hard about this. I don't know if I'm going too deep into it, but it actually, like how I keep on telling people, all things connect to each other no matter what. You might think that somebody so far out in Zimbabwe has nothing to do with you all the way in Mississippi, but they do if you really, really connect the dots. I'm telling you, this is like you really, really have to look at everything. Every single bit. Because if you don't, I'm telling you, you're gonna be lost. It's just like, I know, like again, like I'm just gonna go off a little bit. It's like The Walking Dead. The Walking Dead. It's not just a zombie movie and stuff like that. It's more of if there is an apocalypse, or if there's a big, huge destruction, something happened that there is no electricity. There's it's hard for you to find any food. You can't go to the store and buy stuff because everything is spoiled. How are you going to survive? How are you going to rebuild your community? You understand? That's what The Walking Dead is more about. It's not just because of the zombies. It's about how are you going to survive? Like they say, the strong will survive. The MacGyvers will survive. You understand what I'm saying? Oh my gosh.
Did you not miss her?
I don't know what else to say, but
yeah, what I said so. Yeah.
It's something you really need to think about. Yeah. Look, this is get Foxy Brown. Oh yeah. Wow. Ooh, audio blog people. Dee Dee. Dee Dee, why audio blog?
In the game, coast to coast, stash to get and host a girl. Dark skin, Christian Dior, post a girl. Moroccan Tim's bitch and a Gucci loafer girl. Niggas say I'm too pretty to spit rhymes, gritty. Fuck y'all thought, be dancing around in suits like I'm pretty. Show niggas how we run this city, respect my name. Boogie nickel, stay in your lane like the hurricane. Rains on bitches like Sugar Shane. And dear one of y'all rap bitches to mention Fox name. What's beef? Beef is when bitches think it's sweet. See, I'm frontin' in the streets and let my gas leak. Yo! Sometimes I feel like I'm just too fucking real. I love to stack riches. No disrespect, y'all. I respect the rap game, but I don't fuck with rap bitches. I'm speaking from my heart. It's not that I'm too good, I'm just hood. Been like this from the fucking start. Since I bust my gun in 96. Y'all ain't never see me flick up with them fake ass chicks. Bitches now up in your face, turn around and pop shit. You an industry bitch, I'm a in the streets bitch. I might breeze through Prada, Chloe or Tips, but other than that, it's just me and my six. Rum and whiskey, proper set off, six bet off, gats let off, I speak calm, youngster, then pours off like screech you done, boy, who y'all know rock Prada like box, pop bottles in the back of the cellar with Donatella, Cartier wristwear, Pasha Cage face, niggas stand in line just to get a sneak taste. Like y'all know I keep scat beneath waist. And like 100,000 each crib and each safe. When Fox come through, she all got done to please. I'm like Marion Jones, what? Who the put up Juan Reyes? Listen, never trippin', never catch Brown slipping. Fuck, y'all only nice around mics like Pippin. Shit, to all my thugs, that's blood in the crippin'. I'm still shittin', still old rotten, switchin'.
This is your girl Dee Dee of Wild Olio Blog. I hope everybody is doing okay. Hope everybody is inside warm. Because at nights it'd be really, 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 really cold. And I think the holiday that just passed was President's Day, and I think there's a lot of kids that are off this whole week. So I don't know, a lot of y'all must be like, yeah! Yay! No school! Yes! Damn it! Yeah, people, what is up? I'm like, oh my gosh, I just don't understand, man. What is going on? What's up out there, William Cole? William Cole, man. Phenomenal photographer. Check him out on Facebook. And also for the wonderful and on the ones and twos, DJ Geo Supreme. Check him out on Facebook and on his website. He be giving us the good shiznicks. Let me stop playing. But yeah, people, let me get off of the Apple versus the FBI for a minute. And this talk about, like, how it's saying, how this comes back to the whole thing of control. I know there's a lot of different things of control. Control, when you control somebody, it's like the person has no freedom. If you control your own self, then you are controlling you. You're telling yourself you don't have no freedom. You run by me. That's okay. That's all right. That is okay and all right. But when people really, really, really try to force you to do something that you don't want to do, ain't good. That ain't good. I'm not down with that. And when people try to control the people, that's kind of like a little bit like bullying. Because when you bully someone, you trying to control them. You kind of try to tell them, look, you don't go there until I tell you to. Give me your lunch money. You know, you ain't eating that. You ain't nothing. Like, whatever they believe in, whatever they say, is more important than how you think and what you want to do. It's that type of control, or the control of when you're up to that point in life and you hit the age of 18 and you say to yourself, well, my parents are always trying to control my life and tell me what to do and stuff like that. Maybe I should get myself together, get me a job, give me my own place, then I have a control of what I say and what I do. Because when you're under the roof of your parents and you think that you have a lot of control, that don't happen. That don't work. They let you know right then and there, look, they be singing Janet like, you don't got your own life because I'm in control. You know, if you want control, you can see the door right there and get right out. They sing their own version of control, you know. But it's you have that type of control, and then you have control of when you're an adult. Of you have to grasp the control of how are you going to live your life when you're an adult. How are you going to live? How are you going to move? How you going to support your family? You know, there's all different types of controls. And sometimes there are good controls and there are bad controls. And I'm trying to tell everyone out there that that thing with Apple, I really want to actually just keep an eye on that. Because if they do side with them, it's the whole thing of, what else do we have? You know? What do we have? What do we have? We try to hold on to, you have to have a search warrant to come into your house. But now we see more videos of cops barging all in without a search warrant. So then you look at it and you say to yourself, I'm analyzing, I'm trying to break this down. Then you start to say, you analyze. I'm like, so what is the thing about these laws when it's so easy for anybody to break them? I mean, the people that people are supposed to be, the powers that be, that the ones that put it there, It's like, oh, it's laws for everybody, but it's not law for us. No, it should be a law for everyone. And abide by it. If they have a policy at Apple in writing that says that, listen, we cannot unlock somebody's phone without their permission, and it's in writing, then that's what it is. That's why when you go to court, they always tell you, oh, Mr. Smith or Mrs. Johnson, do you have it in writing? Then what does that mean if they change it over to them? Then what do you have? I don't know if I'm talking at the crack of my ass, people. Let me know something. I'm like, this is really, really honestly got my mind going. Oh, let me get off of that a little bit. I know a lot of people have watched the Grammys, and I was catching up on it. I was really looking forward for The Weeknd and Lauryn Hill, but as I found out that Lauryn Hill got there late, and by the time she got there, they started the performance with The Weeknd, so it was too late for her to get on stage and to do whatever she needed to do and stuff like that. That would have been the highlight of my life because I miss Lauryn Hill. I miss the uniqueness and the creativity of songs not sounding all the same. Something that's going to be different that gives me like, it makes me like listen to it and say, is that who I think it is? And he's like, oh shoot, I didn't know that was such and such and such and such. That's why I'm giving y'all my music pick of, I could say the week, the day, the month, whatever. I have to say Rihanna's Anti. That album, I have to say, baby girl, you have actually made another album that I can listen to the first track all the way to the end. That's just me. And on that note, I give you all thumbs up on that one. Because if I can listen to each song from beginning to end without any problems, you got it. And another thing about how the songs, it's like it's not the same thing. It's not the same thing. I got the feel of grooves from 1940s to 2016 to reggae to Caribbean to I had gotten everything in this one album. I mean, this girl is on a roll. This is what I'm talking about when somebody says having longevity. When you think so far out the box that you don't even see the box. The box is so far away, it looks like a little tiny pea. A little tiny dot. This girl thinks so out the box, it's ridiculous. And when you can do that, you will have longevity. You will be in this industry for years to come. And only the people that's really creative, can do this shit. I mean, really creative. That's the reason why I'm telling you, Rihanna really is flipping on the ball. I definitely have to say that. Okay? Oh, and the Grammys, the outfits, some of them I like, some of them I didn't. Adele, she did really good. Grammys, people that's in charge of the equipment, y'all need to be on your game tighter. You understand? It wasn't, as me being a music person, I can tell that it wasn't Adele's fault, because I could tell like she was a little off at certain points. But when your equipment is not right and you can't hear, because remember, it's her and the pianist. So it's like she really has to, they need to be both in tune with each other. That's another thing that a lot of y'all artists need to start doing, that you have to think about the what ifs. If the microphone goes out or it dips down, y'all need to start practicing it just in case scenarios. So as soon as that happens, y'all be right on point. Be like, well, you can dip out all you want, and we still on point. And what? That's what I'm talking about. I'm like, come on, people. Come on. I'm like, but the Grammys, I really give it to them. LL, LL, Queens in the building, always does his thing. Look sharp, look clean, everything. He always does his thing, so I have no problems with him. Lady Gaga did her thing for the tribute to David Bowie. I mean, on point. Definitely. Kendrick Lamar, have no words. Phenomenal. That's it. That's all I can say. Phenomenal. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep doing what you're doing. Some people use their gift as a platform to let people know and make people aware of what is actually going on in this world and to keep their eyes open. That's what sometimes music can be. To let you know, I got a story to tell, and I want everybody to know exactly what's going on. I'm going to put it through song, and I'm going to let all my people know about this. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, me see, who else was on there that I really, oh, Johnny Depp, you go, man. Johnny Depp, oh my gosh, he is just too damn ridiculous, but I gotta give it to him. He always wanted to play because he started playing off of guitar. So you do your thing. You really, 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 really do your thing. I'm like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Let me stop playing. But you know how that goes. How that goes. But on that note, people. But yeah, just tell me, what is it? I'm like, the Grammys, everything else, you know me, wacky as can be. But yeah, people, look, again, I'm going to say it again. I don't like when people bully people into believing something that they don't want to believe in. You have freedom of whatever you want to believe in. That's fine. I'm not going to tell you what's right or what's wrong because it doesn't give me the right to tell you what's right or what's wrong. You understand what I'm saying? Always research things on your own. Do not depend on people to research things for you. Don't just go on one thing and just read it and believe it. You go and do the research. You understand what I'm saying? Because you can't trust everything that anybody puts out there. You know? The pen is mightier than the sword. The pen is, well, never. But you know what I'm talking about, right? Listen. Let me play y'all another song. I really like this song. I really like it because it has a little bit of Brownstone Soul. I really like it. It's like with Troy Lanez. Say it. I really like this. I'm just gonna play it for now. Listen, this is DZ my audio blog. Enjoy this. Keeping it on it. I love each and every one of you. You were one of your niggas, but wasn't whipping this for you. Wow. Try came back top down. You're gonna have to do more than just. You're gonna have to do less for you. Tell mommy, you know I. Always want you to. You gon' have to do more than just. You gon' have to do less for you. Tell mommy, you know I. So you gon' need to do more than just. Do you know? I got though. Ever since you hopped in, shot my phone, slammed my door. You know I know that you've been on it, but I've been on it, on the low. So let a young nigga get down on it. Yeah, love when you spin round on it. Yeah, even though a young nigga want you. Shawty, I promise the truth, and when I come down on it, yeah, you love when I'm down on it. Yeah, fuck around, spend time on it. Yeah. So I came back top down. You gon' have to do more than just. You gon' have to do less for you. So mommy, you know I always want you to. You gon' have to do more than just. You gon' have to do less for you. So mommy, you know I. So you gon' need to do more than just. Do you know?
snow, baby. Bringing out the foreign not to play, you know it's things to take. So let a young nigga get down on it. Yeah, love when you spin round on it. Yeah, even though a young nigga want you. Shawty, I promise the truth, and when I come down on it, yeah, you'll love when I'm down on it. Yeah, fuck around, spend time on it. Yeah. So I came back top down. You gon' have to do more than just. You gon' have to do less for you. Some mommy, you know I always want you to. You gon' have to do more than just. You gon' have to do less for you. Some mommy, you know I. So you gon' need to do more than just. Do you know?
Do it, prove it, do it, take out the garbage, wash the dishes, do something in the damn house, man. It's your girl Dee Dee of Wild Audio Blog. You know, it's about that time. It's about that time when I have to wrap things up. Oh man, I miss each and every one of you. I'm going to do my little bit of shout outs to, I'm going to give a shout out to Kimiko Bags, Kimmy. Check them out. Kimmy, Shay Shoehaven, DJ Geo Supreme, Natasha, always listening. Love ya. April Walker of Walkerware. Let's see. William Cole, great photographer. Let's see. All my Facebook family. Boogie Brow. CTC Designs. Cobb, everybody, I know I'm missing a lot of people. You know what I need to do? I need to do like make a whole list and just name everybody off that list. But everybody on Facebook, Twitter, everyone that's been following me, supporting me and what I do, I am so humble and thankful that y'all are supporting. But on that note, I also like to thank my parents, my mom and my dad, my cousins, my sisters, my nieces and my nephews, everyone that's out there. Love y'all, love y'all, love y'all. Mrs. A, E, Dosh, Big Dosh, and the crew, Cuzzo, everybody out there. I love each and every one of you. Listen, like I always say, just be careful when you go outside because it's getting to the wire. People are really going berserk out there. So, on that note, be safe. Look both ways before you cross the street, like your mom always tell you, all right? And like I always tell everybody, when you grind hard, you can play hard, okay? So, right now, it's sleepy time, so you can go sleep hard, but make sure you get up in the morning. Listen, people, this is Dee Dee, Wild Audio Blog. Just think about it. All my Apple people out there, think about it and either send me some comments. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Polygram, all the damn grams out there. It's Wow Audio Blog. Just check me out. Write me some comments. Hey, if you happen to have Skype me and what have you. It doesn't matter. But just let me know what your views are. I will be back on Friday to give you more of my wacky and outrageous ideas and views on everything that happens with No Halls Bar. Like I said, that's just me. Girl Next Door, Dee Dee. Love y'all. Be safe and peace.